the Republicans are really, I think, for the most part, doing a fairly good job of keeping their freak flags at half mast, as it were. However, this past week, one guy, I guess, they couldn't contain. I'm talking about the former Republican state senator from Arizona, who is now the former, I guess, number two state Republican Party official, Russell Pearce. And I think you know this guy is... you have some direct hand or first hand familiarity with this guy.
Yeah, we used to party together back in the 80s. No, I kid. When I wrote a book called The Real McCain back in 2008, I went out to Arizona that I think in 2007, that summer, and I was meeting with people a lot like Russell Pearce, and I met with him. And, you know, it's funny because I look back now, and that was this sort of new phenomenon, which we now know to be the Tea Party. But there was sort of this level of far-right conservatism that was based around anti-immigration, no regulations on guns, climate change being a hoax, government spending and these kinds of things. And they were busy calling, if you remember, former Senator John Kyle, they were busy calling him a traitor. And I remember thinking to myself at that point, I didn't get it because I didn't think he could be any more conservative than John Kyle. But Russell Pearce finds a way to be, and he was sort of, you could call it an early indicator of the Tea Party movement. So he was a former state senator. He was a sponsor of SB 1070, which was the strict Arizona anti-immigration bill.
Show me your papers.
Show me your papers.
Part
bill,
of which was overturned by the Supreme Court.
That's correct. And he doesn't, as you, what would shock you is he doesn't have very progressive views on other items either. He ended up becoming the second in command, as you said, the Arizona Republican Party, the vice chair. And he made a comment, I believe it was over the last couple of days, where he said that he thought that female recipients of Medicaid should be sterilized.
You put me in charge of Medicaid, the first thing you do is get a woman Norplant birth control implants or tubal ligations. Then we'll test recipients for drugs and alcohol and nicotine. If you want to produce or use drugs or alcohol, didn't get a job.
Said that if he was the amazing thing was he said that if he was he was on a right wing radio show and he said, you put me in charge of Medicaid, the first thing I do is get Norplant birth control implants or tubal ligations, essentially saying he'll sterilize women on there. Then we'll test for drugs and alcohol. And you want any more children, you got to get a job.
And you have to be tested for drugs and alcohol to be allowed to have kids, and you have to get a job to be allowed to have kids.
Indeed. And the best thing is, of course, the guy, once this gets out there, the Republicans are very afraid of letting their base essentially show themselves in this off year. They think they're going to have quite the year, and by all accounts, they very well may. But
if you want to freak out the RNC these days, you just ask one of the Republican candidates what they think about rape.
And
they would literally grab the person and pull them out of the room.
And we should say that they're not getting helped by Rush Limbaugh this past week.
No.
Who basically said no sometimes actually means yes if you know how to spot it. And, remember,
clearly Rush does.
Right. This is. Of course. And this is the intellectual pillar of the Republican Party. But getting back to Pearce. So he resigns.
But it's important to state with all the influence he's had on all of these issues. He's been most out forward on immigration. But he hadn't spoken maybe in a way that had gotten as much attention on women and on the poor and others before, but he has these same kinds of unbelievably far-right views and associations with, if not Klan groups, militia groups, and others on the far right. So just really open, and he is, if Rush Limbaugh is the intellectual foundation of the overall party, this guy certainly is what you would call the intellectual foundation of the Arizona Republican Party.
Right.
And they've, and obviously now he's resigned from that position, but it doesn't mean anything's going to change.
Yeah.
In terms of his influence there, he'll still be there, and he's got a lot of contacts out there, and it's a You know, I mean, they, again, you're right. They've done their best to hide these guys, and they've really gone all in on making sure that only the very conservative guys who know how to not say stupid things get elected, as opposed to the very conservative guys who do say stupid things.
Right. I've always said that the difference between the Tea Party and the establishment Republican Party at this point is really just a matter of media training.
And I agree with you. I agree with you on that.
In a statement released by the Arizona Republican Party, Pearce was quoted, and you really got to listen to the audio when he's saying this, because he's basically said, look, if I was in charge of these things, I would start basically the sterilization. He said that his comments were written by someone else and that he had failed to attribute them to the author. I mean,
it's called a speechwriter, and everybody has one of them.
They can't even distance themselves from his comments. They basically just said he was quoting somebody else. And not that he didn't believe it, but just that he was quoting somebody else. I mean, it just stunning.
I like to quote people about random right-wing things I don't believe, don't you?
Of course.